is not ready. As he picked up momentum, the security guard gave up and the chase, and there were no match for her. I cried, please help my child. The doctors came to the rescue. Death was negative. Tried to snatch me away again. But God reverted the action because my purpose on earth was not complete. As a child growing up, being slim and quiet and shy, I was often mistaken someone who was rude. After leaving the prep school, I moved to the primary high school and was exposed to sports. There I excelled and ran and got medals. And so my brothers and others now thought that I had some strength. I was happy then and started to feel good about myself and my achievements. My strong, loving dad ensured that he picked me up from school every day. I was a happy child. I often loved him burying my face in the name of his shirt that peeped through one eye as he ran his fingers through my hair. I felt so secure. And oh, my mom, that stern one hand while searching for food for chickens kept a watchful eye on me, ready to spread her wings around me and to defend me at all costs. So protective she was, that she often had to apologize to strangers who meant no harm, but simply wanted to play, you know, just to play with me. One would quickly grab me by my hand and say, I'm sorry. My older brother, Sophie, was always ready to defend me. I was like a mother to blame and drowning as we grew up. During times when mom was away, they couldn't make a wrong move. Discipline was one of my strong attributes, which I displayed constantly when I was with them. And I expected the same from them. I recall one Christmas, we had to exchange presents, and my brothers, they actually bought me two lovely gifts, perfume. And lo and behold, I gave them a cap that they reserved to me, but they rent. The cap said, I can remember, keep your room clean, wash up the dishes, sweep the yard. And this went on. Ryan and Gray, they were so upset because they spent all their savings to buy her perfume and only a cap duty they got. Whenever I cooked, they had better ensure that they finished their chores. Otherwise, I would take the pot of food into my room until they were through, sweeping the yard, even in the night. Whatever else they had to do, they had to do it. They would protest, but when the uncle got better of them, they repented and dinner would be served sometimes at 7 when they were finished. Years after, 7 years after the birth of Ryan, came Andrew, my baby brother. I love him so dearly. I call him Charlie. He was like my little son. In 1995 was a great year for me because in March of that year, I experienced a new birth. I surrendered my life to Christ. 1996 rather. The devil trembled and shook his head in disappointment and disgust as he remembered Genesis 3 verse 15. And I will put enmity between thee and the woman and between thy seed and her seed, and it shall bruise thy head and thou shalt bruise his heel. Amen. The Savior who rescued me from the cold hands of death at birth gave me a new birth and welcomed me officially into the family of God. I was baptized along with my granddad, my mom, Ryan, my cousin Ryan, the evangelist Dad Clement, who had appreciated Edgewater. as I use them to the glory and honor of God. The Port Washington Adventist Church became my spiritual home. I rarely missed a meeting. I was willing to do whatever was asked of me by the leaders or members of the church. I was a member of the youth choir and the mass choir. Also, that was directed by Benji. Oh, what sin has the right to God. Sister Claudia Bailey, the Bible worker at the time, initiated a witnessing group called Manna. Those were beautiful days as we witnessed the worship together. The zeal we had was great. Pastor Dwayne Scott and Wayne Snyder are products of that noble group. Dr. Lenny Bishop, Smith, and many others here today. Our testimony, and so my greeting, our testimony in fact, that we had a spiritual awakening. In the year 2001, I migrated to the United Kingdom after working at that of the Life Insurance Company for a number of years. I went in search for greener pastures. I wanted a better life. The challenges were great, but through all, I never forget my Redeemer and friend. I worked and studied many colleges and universities in order to get my papers. And during the night, I was so alarmed. I was so shocked, to say the least, when I went to Kaylin's apartment, and she also had some things in storage, to see the new. It is just so much study she did in order to get her papers, certificates, and diplomas and degrees. It is too much to mention. She worked so hard because she was not married. And the only thing she could have done was to work hard at school to ensure that she got her learning papers and her citizenship. I was very happy, she said, when her papers came through. The Lord surrounded me with many things, the church family in the UK. And as I went to see at the remarkable service that was there, it was overwhelming. I was a bit surprised to see how many persons who came in, churches from all over, the Skating Center in London, she sat all over the United Kingdom. So many persons knew her and came to the remembrance service. I was then free to visit my family in Jamaica, and so I came in 2013. I was so overjoyed to see them. But in 2018, March, I learned that my granddad was ill and I visited Jamaica. What a God was served. No one knew that my daughter would have passed, but she came and she made her mark, even in this church, to sing even a song so that members can hear it. I was saddened by the punishment, but I took great pleasure in going to talk with him and assist my mom by nursing home for the few weeks that I was around. We went to Jolly's, we had fish together, we went to the beach, we went all over to catch up the things that we need to talk about. I tried to set her straight and tried to recreate me, but I'm not so easy to be recreated. God saw I was tired and weary, so he couldn't get to sleep. I'm awaiting the first resurrection. Satan, you have lost. The negative moves you displayed in my life did not discourage me. Eternal life is what I long for. If in this life alone we have hope, we will be made most miserable. So take it positive for all who believe, because eternal life is the gift of life, the gift of God, that we all will receive if we believe. The negative people, the negative things, were stepping stones which I used to build my life for eternity. It doesn't matter the state I was from when I died. It doesn't matter the cause of death, because whenever I shall rise again, death will not hold me in the grave. I accomplished the work that God gave me to do. I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I've kept the faith, and my crown is assured. And so so many others will join me in Christ's resurrection movement. Today, brethren, I want to say that Gideon was prepared to death, although we didn't do it. We didn't know it, because Gideon at least had recorded 2 songs 2 years before. And these songs will be played at the end. And these songs will tell you definitely that Gideon was warned that she was going to pass. I pray today, if you want to keep your memory alive, live for God, trust Him, and you'll see Gideon once more. Thank you.
the word, share God's word with his people. His colleague in ministry, my friend, we studied together at Northern Kind of University. We served together at greater history of churches, and we are here again together in Portmore. Host pastor for the Portmore Church, very amiable, astute, and assiduous young preacher of God. One that carries his word with tangible tact and tenacious tenacity. I speak of none other than Pastor Dexter Dennis. After the last squad would have prepared the way for the song Jerusalem, we'll hear from the man of God, Pastor Dexter Dennis.
Come on. everyone. Is some occasion that we are gathered, but I want you to remember that even on a sad day, he still serves a good God. But I want to recognize pastors that are here, especially in the presence of Pastor Wayne Stengel and for my friend, Khalid Pastor Warner, and also for my dear Pastor Wayne Stop, who is here with us, to all the other receiver verses that are here. Thank you. I will be standing here for the next 5 days. But I'm going to be in it somewhere. Now, if you see me standing for more than 5 days, I want you to start saying amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. When I would have heard those things, then it would give me the signal that it's time for me to take my seat. Amen? Yes. Decide to hurry, you have to be given a chance. But if there's something that you want to praise God for, as the word is delivered in the next few minutes, praise God with me. I want to receiving a clear word from the scripture passage, 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 19 to 22. 1 Corinthians 15, 19 to 22. The Bible says, and I've been hearing the echo. If it is like only, we have hope in Christ. We are of all then most miserable. But now is Christ risen from the dead and become the first fruits of them that sleep. For since by man came death, by man came also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all died, even so, in Christ, shall all be made alive. Grass withers, the flowers fade, the word of our God stands for a promise to be as we pray. Father, I ask now for the next few minutes that you will tune the hearts of your people heavenward. Lord, as they are grieving, the ordinances have been made. Lord, as a church, we are also grieving. But I ask now that the Holy Spirit's power will move and comfort the hearts of these your children. Give me a word of hope and encouragement. In Jesus' name we pray. There are many things to hope for in this life. When you are in school, you hope to graduate. When a woman is pregnant, the hope is that one day she will give birth. When you are tired, the hope is that you will get home soon to get some sleep. When you are single, the hope is that one day somebody will marry you. But when you are a true child of God, the hope that you have is not based on the fact that you're married or not. The hope that you have is not based on the fact that you're tired or not. When you are a child of God, the hope that you have is firmly rooted and grounded in Jesus Christ. Can do, then your hope doesn't have any root or foundation. the test of time.
We thank you for the presence of the Holy Spirit.
made in the lives of others. We thank you for the cherished experiences we have, and now for the precious memories we can carry with us. I commit into your hands our mom, Sister Frances, the many children, every family member and friend. Lead us comfortably, pray. Sustain us through these moments of deep grief, this year of mourning. May we go beyond the darkness and the pain of death and suffering this life to the great morning when Jesus shall come. And death will be no more. And your people who have died in you will rise to meet Christ and be saved. They shall both join in heaven and be with you forevermore. We ask that you help us to make the necessary decision and preparation to be in the number when the saints go marching in. Keep us faithful, therefore. Help us be obedient in all we do and we say. For these mercies we ask, for that name I pray. In Jesus' name, let everyone say, amen.
You may be seated for the final instructions. It's not often that I can say this, but I'm sure you will agree with me when I say we have had a wonderful time today. Yes, we have. Not many services like these you can say that for. But today, I am sure that our hearts were lifted up in prayer. Yeah.